Cheryl Powers here does a lot of the silviculture at the Malcolm Knapp Research Forest. So she's going to spend today with me talking about some different forest stands and the different management activities that have happened in them. So Cheryl, can you talk a little bit about the stand that we're in right now?
Sure. So we're at a stand that naturally regenerated after a logging disturbance that happened in the 1920s. And then that was followed by a wildfire in 1931. So if you look around in here, you can see some really large, very old stumps. And you can still see burn scars on those old stumps.
I think we got a big one right behind us here.
Exactly. Perfect. Thanks, Patrick. And so you can see the evidence of that. And so this naturally regenerated stand, having originated from this 1931 wildfire, makes this stand about 75 to 80 years old. You know, natural regeneration comes in, you know, over a time period, and it takes some time because that was a very, very large disturbance. And it takes time for the seed, you know, to come back into the area. So what we're seeing now is a natural mixture of Douglas fir, western hemlock, and western red cedar. Those are the three main species here.
Okay, and I noticed, so clearly there's been some recent management activity here. I see some fresh stumps.
Right.
There's some fresh slash on the ground. So can you talk a little bit about what's been what management activities have been done at this stand recently?
Right, so what we've done here is we've done a commercial thinning. And a commercial thinning is a stand tending treatment that you do. There's many stand tending treatments that we can do along the way between regeneration and final harvest. And the point of a thinning, it's never about creating new regeneration. That's not the purpose of it. The purpose is to do a silvicultural treatment that's going to improve the stand in some way that's going to increase its value for the future.
So you're taking out a proportion of the trees, so to what we would say release the remaining trees so that they can have an increase in growth and potentially an increase in quality.
That's right. So what you do is you remove a proportion of the forest, and when I call it commercial thinning, commercial just means that instead of leaving the trees that we cut on the ground, we're going to use them in some way. And that's the commercial component. It means that there's going to be some sort of a product that we're going to take out of here. And it doesn't necessarily have to be profitable even, but if we're going to take something out, then that makes it a commercial thinning because there is some value to the part that we're removing, as well as this investment in the future value of the stand.
And when you plan a thinning, do you mark individual trees to be harvested, or how do you, and if so, how do you determine which trees you're going to have harvested and which trees you're going to keep?
Mm-hmm. Well, first of all, in any thinning, the timing is really crucial. You know, you need to understand the trajectory of growth and the plan is to increase the value, so you want to make it so that you're timing it well and you're taking the right amount. And you may be doing a number of thinnings over time, so you need to have it worked into a crop plan where you are able to predict the growth of the stand over time.
And then when you've decided to do a thinning, how do you go about choosing which trees to harvest and which trees to leave?
Right, so you've designed a treatment and you know what level of removal is going to be best from a silvicultural standpoint, and that's taking a whole lot of things into consideration. Mostly it's to do with the health and the resilience and the growing space that would be needed by the trees that you're going to be leaving. So you want to keep the stand healthy, you want to keep it stable, you want to be able to remove trees without damaging the ones that you leave behind. That's really, really critical because you don't want to introduce some sort of a health issue. And there are many potential things that can go wrong. If you thin a stand too much, you're losing some of the site occupancy. The growing space isn't being utilized. If you damage some of the trees that you leave behind, you could be introducing pathogens. If you are taking out the wrong ones and leaving ones that are unstable, perhaps wind damage could happen. So lots of things can go wrong. So the selection of trees is really important. You want to choose ones that are stable and healthy and that you can work around at a certain spatial arrangement and take the commercial extraction part of it out without damaging what you leave behind. So they're very carefully chosen. There's usually a level of removal, like a proportion of the volume, but much more often it's based on basal area. It's just an easier way to do it. And then we're working out approximately what sort of an intertree spacing would be ideal. And that's taking into consideration what's going to be the logging method too, the extraction method. So we need to have enough space to actually, in this case, get machinery in here and actually fell the trees and pick up the trees and move them out of the stand.
In this stand, do you know approximately what proportion of the basal area was removed in the thinning?
Yeah, so remember I said that this is not a regeneration system. So we're not trying to achieve regeneration. There might be a little bit of incidental. Certainly the forest floor is going to green up after a thinning to some extent. But the goal is not to have, a new cohort or wave of regeneration. So the proportion that you want to remove is really important. We want to give more growing space to the valuable trees that we've left behind. And we found that in this forest type, in this type of stand, about a 40 to 45% removal is about right for a commercial thinning at this stage. So that's what we were aiming for here.
All right. Thank you.